found in the ice.
So you're aware
of Neanderthal man.
Right, yeah. Ricky, do you know
not
about
a monkey,
the
Iceland?
No, no, I know, but I just was looking at, like, info.
Right. The 5,000-year-old fella who was preserved in a glacier. That one.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Do you find that more fascinating than the monkey?
Well, I know that it's true.
Yeah, it is true, but do you find it more fascinating?
Well, simply because it's true, I find it more fascinating. I can't act on some, if someone, anything that's true is more fascinating.
But, you see, what I get from the monkey thing, you
yeah.
go, oh, I wonder if it was happy about that, and...
But you accept it straight away, you accept that that is true and interesting, and I don't know what that is. I mean, to me it sounds like a bit of cruelty towards animals.
No, yeah, yeah.
Because, I mean, if that's true, it's disgusting to tattoo a monkey's head. It's disgusting.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
There's no way, that's what I'm saying. It doesn't do a- If a monkey, if they reported that a monkey, went in and got a tattoo, and chose it itself, and then was riding a Harley Davidson down Canberra, I'd go, that is incredible. But I'd really want to see it on the news, and it mustn't be anywhere near the 1st of April. You know what I mean?
I think you've just blown next week's.
Letter to Hermione, David Bowie off Space Oddity album, XFM 104.9. See, I don't know where, I thought you'd sort of learned a little bit, Carl, what is an interesting fact and what might just be a mentalist online. Do you know what I mean? Do you know what point we're making here? Why the truth is so much more fat? Even a little bit, even something that's just, you know, mild but is definitely the truth is so much more interesting than just wish fulfillment of truth. To me, if it starts with there was this ghost, right, it's not interesting. You could say anything. There was this ghost that could turn custard into wine. It doesn't matter. There was this ghost that had 9 heads. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. There was this
Carl's looking at you going, there's a ghost that can turn custard into wine.
Yeah. It doesn't matter what you say after that. There's a ghost that can swallow alligators whole. The premise means it's not true to me. Do you know what I mean? It's like people say, you know what? God, right? He's incredible. I go, I'll stop you there. The fact that he can make the earth in 7 days, well, you've lost me already. Do you know what I mean? Whereas someone says something like, you know, a cockroach can live 5 days without a head, that's interesting. That's interesting.
Right.
Do you think when you die, they say, you're a ghost, this is going to amaze you. You yeah. can go and you can spook people out.
Yeah.
Do you like custard? Come over here.
No. Well, if you don't, oh, you don't. Do you like wine? Of course I do. Oh, you are going to love it.
You're going to love me. You're going to love it. I've lost all my loved ones.
Yeah. Do you see what I mean? It's what your sort of beliefs are based on. Mine are sort of on... I suppose logic and science and so but what, I'm amazed by the world and
so the Iceman, why does that amaze you? What's like ooh?
Well, they found some part of our preserved past. You know, it's interesting. Again, I'm amazed by anthropology and evolution.
Yeah, just that line on its own like that. You know, they found an Iceman is great, but then it went on and it's going on about. You know, they've had to get different people involved to find out how old it was. Because first of all, the story started off, right, an old fellow on holiday somewhere, where did they find it, in Sweden or something? And he was walking in the hills, and-
He was walking?
In the hills.
In heels? Was he a transvestite?
In the mountains.
Oh, right.
In the hills?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So he's walking about, and he sees this body in the snow, and he thinks, oh. So he calls the police up. And they come and have a look and he goes, oh yeah, it's probably a murder. So then they dig it up and find out he's got hold of a spear in his hand.
Right, and he's dressed like Fred Flintstone.
Yeah.
Right. Then they realise it's probably not a recent murder.
Right.
His knuckles are dragging on the floor, he's
yeah.
a Neanderthal man, they
yeah.
think, hang on, Carl Pilkington.
But when they found out, hang on, it's an old thing.
It's an old thing!
Can it? If it was a murder recent, then you'd go, hang on, how did this happen, who does he belong to?
Yeah.
But the chances are whoever murdered him is also dead.
5,000 years ago, probably, yeah.
So leave it. Just bury it.
I don't think it's a murder investigation.
No, but they are.
It's not Quincy going, this is really, this was before my time.
It's not a murder investigation.
Just one thing bothers me, sir. Just one final thing. My wife loves you, but this guy.
That's how they were.
Why would
it?
He have a spear and a leopard skin? I just can't get over this. What are you talking about?
That's what I'm saying.
What are you saying? Right, shut up, everybody. What are you saying? You've got one chance now. You've got to ask me a question, and I will answer it the best way. But what are you saying?
What is
your question?
Right, he probably spent a load of money.
That's not a question.
Yeah, but let me tell you what I'm saying. Right, they're probably spending a load of money finding out stuff about this fella who died. And even if he wasn't murdered, he'd be dead by now anyway. So get over it. Right? 3,000 years ago, he died. Right. So then they start messing about with it. Saying, well, how did he die? Well, it doesn't matter. It was ages ago. Then you start digging his belly open, seeing last meal that he ate.
Yeah.
Oh, he ate seeds and leaves. Well, no surprise, really. He was not else around. Again, spending more money. Someone's been paid money to sort that out. Then they bury him, and then said, hang on a minute, are you sure that he died by, like, a spear? Let's dig him up again. So they dig him up again. And find some splinter or something.
I don't believe they buried him.
They did. Well, in some sort of fancy coffin so everyone can see him. But for me, that is more wasteful than sorting out something that's, you know, like someone who's ill. Sort something out, you know.
It's not either or. They didn't pull a doctor out of surgery.
Exactly. There's not an old man in a bed in a corner or somewhere.
Yeah, Ted, what are you doing? Stomach? I'm just giving this bloke a stat clear. No, look, we found an old fella in a skit. Okay, take over. It's not either or, Carl. What are you talking about? It's scientific research.
But don't you see why this is fascinating? It gives us an insight into how we lived 3,000, 5,000 years ago. That's an incredible historical document.
What if it was your equivalent? What if he was like the Carl of the time and there's people, you know, ghosts now, through there going, oh God, I don't believe it. They've dug up Carl. They think we're all like that. Oh no, they're going into his brain now. They're looking at how his brain works. We're going to get such a bad rep. Oh,
well,
dear.
Each to their own, if you like it. I just thought it was a bit of a...
waste of money.
A little bit of a waste.
Yeah, okay.
But, there you go. Anyway, we'll give out the answers to Rockbusters next.
If we must.
Yeah. It sometimes stuns me.
Mm.
Sometimes I'm taken aback, do you know what I mean?
But what worries me is if one day aliens do visit...
I'd love
and
that.
They come down, yeah. But what worries me is they might bump into... What if they bump into you and they think that you represent mankind?
And they go up and they start another planet.
They're gonna act, they say, we'll ask you three questions, and if you answer them correctly, we will not blow up your planet.
Yeah.
We'd be doomed.
It depends.
Well, they ask you, don't they? What if they said, right, Carl, what's the weirdest thing ever found in China?
I say, every Chinese kid.
And they go,
okay,
right.
Okay, interesting.
Two, all right.
What don't you see anymore?
What do you see an old bloke doing?
Don't see an old fella eating a Twix.
Yeah. And they say, what if they asked you, what's across the road from you when you're washing up?
Well, there's three things. Do you just want one of them?
No, yeah. I want all three.
You want all three? It was a Chinese kid dancing about in his underpants.
Yeah.
There was a bouncer every night getting ready to go to work. And the third one, the old woman reading a book, the same book.
And they
night.
Go, right, your planet's saved. See,
Gorg, back in the ship.
Yeah,
they are a superior race. Eve, featuring Gwen Stefani. Let me blow your mind.
XFM, 104.9. Well... Moving on.
Answers?
Nearly done. Let's play Rockbusters.
Alright, first one was, the Australian picks two blokes. The initial was E. The answer there, Eminem. Eminem. Alright, the second one, that builder is a bit cute. The initials there were BT. That was Bonnie Tyler. And... And then we introduced a new bit to the show. That song sounds all right. These were the effects you heard. And that was Prodigy. Smack my bitch up.
Who are you punching there?
And could I just say, no animal was harmed in the taping of that effect.
There you go.
No.
Right, so have you got a winner?
Yes, Rob Preston from Croydon, he has got all three correct, and he wins a selection
bag
of shite. Exactly. So, yeah, so good luck. Enjoy that, Rob.
If you can.
Yeah.
Sell it. Record and tape exchange within 40 minutes of receiving it, I imagine, the one good album that he likes. Bob Dylan on the tracks for all this bag of shite, please.